Hi, this is Troy from ghostsofnorthamerica.com. That's me on the right. That's my friend Terry, also known as Rat, on the left. You may or may not be familiar with what we do from another website we have called ghostsofnorthdakota.com. We go out and we drive all over the place and we photograph abandoned places and ghost towns. Well, this video is the first time we traveled outside the state of North Dakota for our new website, ghostsofnorthamerica.com, to check out a few abandoned places in South Dakota and Nebraska, including the Devil's Nest Ski Resort, which turned out to be the highlight of our trip. But I want to give away all the good stuff right away. Let's start with Porter Sculpture Park. This is Wayne Porter's labor of love. It's a roadside attraction just west of Sioux Falls on Interstate 90. We met Wayne Porter, and he is an eccentric character with an incredible talent for art. But we noticed definite influences from artists like the Brothers Quay and even Dr. Seuss.
Sculpture Park, met Wayne Porter, and like, what an artist, right?
Yeah, and it's crazy, that giant bull's head, I guess Egyptian in nature, but is massive, and I can't imagine putting that together and getting it out to that location.
He's got such a unique style and vision for his art.
It's just the kind of roadside place that you know, people aren't going to set out as to go there as their destination, but when you run across something like that on the side of the road, it's so cool.
Oh, and it's kind of a throwback to the past, too, because, you know, you forget how prevalent those things were, and they were essentially a draw to get people off the main thoroughfare,
right,
and stop, and, you know, he's clearly doing a good job, and even while we were there, another couple had come to visit, so it always makes you wonder how many people stop there in a given day.
Yeah.
It does make you nostalgic for an earlier time, too, when the roadside, you know, waypoints and a wayside rest and roadside diners and tourist attractions were commonplace. People weren't zipping by at 80 miles an hour on the interstate.
I think that might have been one of the changes, is people used to travel for the sake of traveling, whereas now we're very destination-focused. Point A to point B,
right?
And you forget that there's many points in between there where you could stop and find out things that you didn't even realize were there.
So we stopped in Sioux Falls for lunch, and then our next stop was the Klondike Bridge on the border between South Dakota and Iowa. Believe it or not, this bridge carried highway traffic between South Dakota and Iowa until the 1970s. Something we encounter everywhere we go.
Waving country.
Recording. Do we want to go low road or high road?
Low road.
So we caused a little controversy when we originally posted this photo gallery because we were accused of trespassing. But you'll notice the gate, it's the cable on the ground right there. There were no trespassing signs anywhere that we could see. So we walked down into the old Devil's Nest Ski Resort. And it was quite a walk. It was probably 3/4 of a mile downhill. Devil's Nest Ski Resort is in Knox County. It's not far from the recreation areas on Lewis and Clark Lake. This was originally going to be a big luxury resort. They had a 25-story hotel planned. But according to a story in the Sioux City Journal, in 1974, the Nebraska Secretary of State dissolved the Devil's Nest Development Company for non-payment of corporate occupation taxes, Some banks foreclosed on the property the following year, and the property was sold at auction to satisfy judgments in 1977. The current owner of Devil's Nest bought it in 2008. Today, there are multiple lots and homes for sale in what is otherwise a largely forgotten venture.
Sometimes I think we should bring a harness for some of this stuff.
The terrain at Devil's Nest is forbidding. As a matter of fact, there's some local history that says the rugged terrain is one reason that Jesse James and his gang once hung out in this area. After walking through Devil's Nest, we thought it might be a perfect place to set an episode of The Walking Dead. As you can see from the sky in the distance there, the bad weather that we'd been hearing hints of all day started to close in on us.
You think we should shut this thing off?
Yeah, probably.
About 60 seconds after I turned that camera off, a cold breeze blew in. We took off walking as fast as we could to get back to the car, hoping that we would get there before the rain got to us.
It was fun.
I think we left like maybe 5 minutes too late. We just got soaked. We're at Devil's Nest Ski Resort in Nebraska, and we heard the thunder, and we did not heed the warning.
No. We thought it was gonna just barely scoot by, and then we saw it starting to come in and went, oh no, and we, I think, didn't factor in too well that it was a downhill climb there. It was an uphill climb up.
And we probably could have driven farther than we did, but we're in a hybrid, so. So it looks like ghost towning is done for tonight.
Yeah. Heading west through Nebraska now, on Nebraska 12 to Verdell, Nebraska. I think that's how you say it.
Unless it's fancy, then it's, or less fancy, Verdell.
You city slicker, it's Verdell, Nebraska. Where are you from?
You got a purty mouth.
What?
What did he say?
Suddenly we're down south.
All of this will get cut out later, so it doesn't matter. This is Manawai, Nebraska, and it holds the distinction of being the smallest incorporated city in the United States. There's only one remaining resident. Her name is Elsie Eiler. And we're told that she opens the bar in Manawai every morning at 9 a.m. You can count on her being there. This church, on the other hand, hasn't been used in 50 years. We read somewhere the last time it was used was when they held Elsie's father's funeral here.
Steeple. If I step on that door, it could put some weight on the wall, which could cause the roof to fall in on top of me, so I'm not gonna go in. You can see somebody had a beekeeping operation. They got all their beekeeping stuff in here. And the tires. I don't know if that was a bat or a bird or what. even see anything in there. Ooh, feet very wet.
South Dakota, and a guy on our Facebook page made a comment about it. What is there?
Jeffrey Blasig said, Zell, South Dakota, abandoned convent building. You're welcome. It's gorgeous. Also, south side of the road, check out the graveyard, and if you can, photograph the tombstone with the angel that's on the edge of the yard. Can't miss her.
Awesome. Let's check it out.
Thanks for watching this video today. If you want to see more of Ghosts of North America stuff, you can check it out at ghostsofnorthamerica.com.